Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. So in my previous sessions, I discussed on histogram equalization and histogram specification. Also, we have solved problems on histogram equalization and specification. In today's session, I am going to illustrate the effect of histogram equalization and specification with an example. So for that, look at this figure. So this is an image of Mars moon, which is called as Phobos, and it is captured by NASA's Mars Global Surveyor. And this image is a poor quality image. Here, the dominant part of this image is that it has large darker regions, and many of the details is hidden in this dark region. So we need to improve the quality of this image in order to identify these fine details. So look at that figure 2. So this is the intensity graph of this original image, and this intensity graph says that the pixels are concentrated towards the lower intensity level, that is towards the darker region. So in order to improve the quality of this image, we need to go for histogram processing, right? At a first glance of this image, one would feel that histogram equalization would be the better approach. So now look into the figure 2. Now look at this figure. So this image is the result of histogram equalization performed on the original image. Okay, so here this histogram equalization is performed using the transformation function, which is shown in figure 1, and here the figure 2 shows the histogram of this particular image. So this histogram says that here the pixels are concentrated towards the brighter region, and it is increased all of a sudden at around 190 intensity value, right? So there are no pixels intensity values in the range 0 to 190, right? So this says that the histogram is not uniform and it is not distributed. So probably this will not give a good quality image. Also, we can make out that from the image itself. So look at that image. So from this image, we can say that this gives washed out appearance. So that means even here the details are not clear. So histogram equalization does not serve well for this kind of applications. So now let us look into histogram specification. So the reasonable approach would be to go for specified histogram. So now look at this figure 3. So this image is the result of specified histogram or histogram specification, which is performed using the specific intensity value as shown in this figure 1. And this figure 2 shows the transformation function, and this histogram specification is performed using the transformation function curve 2. Okay, so the image is enhanced by using the mapping with transformation curve 2. Okay, and figure 3 shows the histogram of this particular image. From this histogram, we can make out that the intensities are uniform and it is distributed over the wide range of intensities. As well, from the image itself, we can make out that this is a good quality image. This gives better contrast, and here we can identify the fine details which is present in this particular image. So if at all you look into this example, we can say that histogram specification would be the best approach for such applications. Okay. So next is local histogram processing. The histogram processing methods which I have described in my previous sessions are global. That means there the transformation functions were applied on the entire image. So we were applying the transformation functions on the entire image in case of histogram equalization as in the case of histogram specification. So this type of approach we call as global approach. Okay, although this global approach gives very good overall enhancement of the image, there are cases where it is very necessary to improve the small areas present in the image. So in such cases, we may have to choose local histogram processing. Okay, so this local histogram processing is very similar to the global histogram processing. In global approach, we apply transformation function on the entire image, whereas in local histogram processing, we apply transformation function on the neighborhood of the pixel. So in this, the procedure is like this. First, we define the neighborhood of this pixel and we apply transformation function on this neighborhood, and the resultant intensity value is assigned to this center pixel. We perform same operation for each and every pixel which is present in this image, starting from the origin. So from pixel to pixel we perform this operation, okay, which we call as local histogram processing. So let us consider an example to illustrate this local histogram processing. So now look at this image. Okay, at a first glance it appears that there are 5 dark squares on gray background, right? And this image also has some noise, but it is imperceptible. Okay, now look at figure 2. So which is the result of global histogram equalization? So in that figure 2, there we can observe that the noises have been enhanced, right? As well, there are some objects which is present in this darker squares and it is not significantly visible in figure 2, right? So this global histogram equalization would not be the best approach. So now let us look into the local histogram equalization. Now look at the figure 3. Okay, so this is the result of local histogram equalization. So here in that particular image, you can easily identify the small objects which are present in the darker squares. Right, so here these small objects are significantly visible in the last image, that is in local histogram equalization. So from this example we can say that local histogram processing would be the best approach in such applications than the global histogram processing. Okay, so the next is histogram statistics for enhanced images. So now here in this, to enhance the images, we have some statistics like mean of the intensity values as well as the intensity variance with respect to the pixels. Okay, so here the mean and the intensity variance expressions can be described with the help of histogram as well without using histogram. Okay, so let me consider the image where let R be the discrete random variable representing the intensity values in the range 0 to L minus 1, and let P of R I be the normalized histogram or This can also be called as the probability that the intensity or occurs in the image. Okay, so using this histogram, that is normalized histogram, let us try to find out the expression for the mean and the standard deviation. Okay, so the nth moment of the mean is represented as mu n of r, which is equal to summation I is equal to 0 to L minus 1 or I minus m whole power n into P of ri. This I call as equation number 1. So where m is the mean, or average intensity of R. So this mean can be expressed as summation I is equal to 0 to L minus 1 or I into P of Ri. This I call as equation number 2. So here this is the expression for mean if at all we know the normalized histogram of the image. Okay, so if this probability density function is known, then the formula used to find out the mean is given in this equation number 2. Now the second moment is also of particular importance because that gives the intensity variance. Okay, the second moment is of particular importance therefore, so this is for the nth moment, so I need to find out the same for the second moment, therefore this expression becomes summation I is equal to 0 to L minus 1 or I minus m whole power 2 into P of Ri. This I call as equation number 3. This equation number 3 is nothing but the standard deviation, or it is also called as intensity variance. So now these two are the expressions which are used to find out the mean and the intensity variance if at all the probability density function of the input image is given. Okay, without using this normalized histogram, we can find out this mean and intensity variance that we call as sample mean and sample variance. Okay, so the sample mean and sample variance can be expressed as m is equal to 1 by mn summation x is equal to 0 to n minus 1, summation y is equal to 0 to n minus 1, f of x comma y. Okay, so the sample variance sigma square, which is also called as standard deviation, this can be measured using 1 by mn summation x equals 0 to m minus 1 and summation y equals 0 to n minus 1 f of x comma y minus m whole square. This I call as equation number 2, where x varies from 0 to m minus 1 and y varies from 0 to n minus 1. So what does it mean here? In this, the mean and the standard deviation of the image whose histogram is known can be calculated using the expressions 2 and 3. If the histogram of the image is not known, even then we can find out the mean and the standard deviation, which we call as sample mean and sample variance. That can be calculated using the expressions, that is 4 and 5. Okay, so here the mean and standard deviation from equations 2 and 3 and mean and standard deviation from equations 4 and 5 results identical. Okay, so these two values will be identical. So to illustrate that, let me consider an example. Okay, consider the following 2-bit image of size 5 cross 5. So now this is the given image. So consider the 2-bit image of size 5 cross 5. So this is the given image. So here this example I have considered to illustrate the results of mean if the histogram of the image is known and if the histogram of the image is not known. Okay, to compare these two results I have considered this example. So if in this example it says that it is a 2-bit image, therefore the intensity level L is equal to integer power of 2. So K is equal to 2 here, this is equal to 4. That means here we have 4 intensity levels. So that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. Yeah, we have 0, 1, 2 and 3. 4 discrete intensity levels in this particular image. And the size of this image is... image size is m cross n. What is m here? M is the number of rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And n is the number of columns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here also it is given in the question. So m cross n is 5 cross 5, which is equal to 25 pixels. So this is the size of the image. So now for this image, let us say that in first case, the histogram of this image is known. So we need to find out the histogram, normalized histogram of this image. So case 1, using histogram. So to find out the mean of this image using histogram, so first we need to find out the probability density function. Okay, so here we have 4 intensity value pixels, right? So P of R naught is equal to, let us say that there are 4 discrete intensity values. This is R naught, R1, R2 and R3. Okay, so R0 is 0. So we know the generalized expression for normalized histogram, which is equal to P of Ri is equal to Ni by Mn. Right. So what is Ni? Total number of pixels having this particular intensity value. So therefore, the number of pixels having the intensity value or not is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have 6 pixels and total number of pixels is 25. So 6 by 25 is equal to 0.24. So similarly, let us find out for P of R1. So the number of pixels having this intensity value 1. So this is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 by 25, which is equal to 0.28. Now similarly, let us find out P of R2. So number of pixels with intensity value 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So again 7 by 25, which is equal to 0.28. Next, probability of pixels with R3. So this is equal to number of pixels with intensity level 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 divided by 25, which is equal to 0.20. Now I got these values. So in order to find out the mean, using this probability density function, the formula is m is equal to summation of I varying from 0 to L minus 1 or I into P of Ri. So what is L minus 1 here? So L minus 1 is 3. So this is equal to summation I equals 0 to 3 or I into P of Ri. So this can be written as, for I is equal to 0, this is R0 into P of R0. For I is equal to 1, R1, P of R1. For I is equal to 2, R2, P of R2. For I is equal to 3, R3, P of R3. Now substitute these values here. So this is equal to R0 is 0. Into P of R0 is 0.24. R1 is 1. Into P of R1 is 0.28. R2 is 2. Into P of R2 is 0.28. R3 is 3. Into P of R3 is 0.20. So reducing this, we will get this as 1.44. So this is the value of mean using histogram equation. Okay. So now let us consider the case 2. So there we are finding the mean value, that is the sample mean, where the histogram of the image is not known. Okay. So in first case, we use the mean formula for the like when we know the histogram, the probability density function of the image. So we need to use the formula of mean, which is shown in, which is as shown in case 1. Okay. So now here in this case 2, we find out sample mean. That means here we can find out the mean value if suppose the histogram of this image is not known or the probability density function of this image is not known, then also we can find out the mean value of this image, that is directly from the image pixels we can find out. So for that, the sample mean formula what we are using is M is equal to 1 by Mn summation x equals 0 to m minus 1 summation y equals 0 to n minus 1 f of x comma y. Okay, so now here let this whole image be called as f of x comma y. Okay, so here we need to find out the mean value of the intensities of all these pixels. So the mean value means the average intensity value. So 1 divided by the total number of pixels is 25. Summation x equals 0 to m minus 1. M is 5 here, therefore m minus 1 is 4. Summation y equals 0 to n is 5, therefore n minus 1 is 4. F of x comma y. So that means here we need to find out the average value of all the intensities which is present in this figure, in this image. So now here summation x equals 0 to 4, summation y equals 0 to 4, f of x comma y represents, it is the sum of each and every pixel present in this image. So this can be written as, so there are 6 pixels having 0 intensity and there are 7 pixels having intensity value 1 and there are 7 pixels having intensity value 2 and there are 5 pixels having intensity value 3. So simplify this expression. So M is equal to 1.44. So now compare the results of case 1 and case 2. It is same. The results are identical. M is equal to 1.44 in both the cases. So you can use any formula for mean. So if at all the histogram of the image is known, then we use the case 1 formula to find out the mean, and if the histogram is not known for a particular image, we use the sample mean formula as shown in case 2. Okay, so this is all about the histogram statistics for an image enhancement. Okay, in my next session I will be starting with fundamentals of spatial filtering. Okay, thank you.